Hello everybody, my name is Dave Snyder. Today I'm going to walk through one of my favorite command line programs, the NNN file manager. So NNN is pretty fantastic. It's the reasons to love it are that it's very fast and very extensible. I'm going to walk through just the basics of how to get it set up, ways that I've configured it, things like getting icons, changing the colors, and then we're going to walk through probably the most of this video will just be on setting up plugins and using the plugin system, which I think is where the power of NNN sort of comes into play. So the first thing to do is how do you actually install NNN? It's going to be different depending upon your computer. You're going to, if you're on Arch like I am, you just install it through the R system. You could use Brew, you can use sort of any of these kind of systems out there. You could even compile it from source. So let's look and see what NNN looks like when we run it for its first time. You know, by default, NNN, it's a file manager. You run it within your terminal. You can then, you know, jump around, look within those directories. I'm using Vim key commands to jump around in here. Makes it pretty simple. You can sort of quit out beyond that. One thing that I was surprised at when I tried it out the first time is there was this screenshot here that showed NNN with a bunch of icons. Mine didn't have any icons. I also didn't necessarily like the colors that were in there. I'm going to show you real quick just how to get that done. It's kind of a good news, bad news thing. The bad news is you will have to compile NNN. To make all that stuff work. The good news is it's not very hard. I'm going to show you how to do it right now. So you're just going to want to clone that directory. Just put it somewhere on your file system. I've already done that. It's in my code NNN directory. And then the next thing that I can do is come in here and we just need to run the make command on it. If you want icons, you have to pass a very specific flag. There's one of two flags that you can use. If you go into the wiki and just search for icons, you'll find how this stuff gets set up. But the very basics of it are if you're already using nerd font icons, like probably most Vim users are, you can just pass this zero or O nerd flag and it will start using those icons. Otherwise you can use the O underscore icons one, which would use a system like icons in terminal. Doesn't really matter which one you use. They have slight differences. People have preferences. More than likely, if you're a terminal user using NNN, you probably already have one of these things on there. All you have to know is that you have to do a compile with that flag. As you can see, it runs fairly fast. And then it just lives within that directory. So now we can run NNN within there and you can see that it's running. So from there, we just need to actually move it to wherever you want that stuff to live. I'm gonna move it to my bin directory. That's where things normally get installed for Arch. And now when I go into my home directory and invoke NNN, you can see that it exists there. Now, I got to this point and I was like, you know what? I still don't like the way that it looks. I don't really like the idea that the folder colors should be blue. To me, I always think of folder colors, maybe I'm old school, I think of them as like vanilla folders. I don't even know what the word vanilla means, but I always think vanilla, and I think just that sort of creamy style color. So that's a good opportunity to show you how NNN's config systems, or to be honest, its lack of config systems exist. The thing to know is that with NNN, you actually need to export variables into your environment for NNN to pick them up. So there's no config file. There's not a YAML file you edit. It's not like a lot of other systems that you might be running. You actually just export variables that NNN listens for. So we're going to do that. I am a fish user, though most people are probably going to be using bash. The basic idea are you just need to export a bunch of these variables to whatever you're using. I'm going to show you how to do that within fish. So I'm going to go into my .config fish directory, and then I'm going to open, I've got a fish file in here that I source against my main config.fish file. I've already commented out a lot of these things. It's just a little quicker to show it. I'm going to show you the config systems that, or the config variables that more than likely you're going to set if you're using NNN for any period of time. The first is you're going to turn on plugins for NNN. I'm going to walk through a little bit more of how you set up those plugins, but the first thing that you need to know is to tell NNN to use plugins, you need to export the NNN underscore plug variable. I'm then going to export a fcolors variable that NNN has given me. This is what allows you to change the colors of those files that are showing up in there. That's where we're going to change basically that blue color to a cream color for our directories. I also like to alias NNN to LS itself. That's how good I think NNN is that I think it can just be a complete LS replacement. And then the last thing is another thing that's very close to that plugin system. You need to export a temp file, a FIFO file that NNN can write to whenever it needs to do previews within that system. So let's write this real quick. I'm going to leave this this terminal open because we're going to come back to it. But let's go and look at that output so that we can see, yes, it is working. So now we've got those cream colored folders, which is something that I would expect to work against. So before we go too much in the plugin system, I kind of want to show what the plugins are, why they're powerful, and we're just going to show off a couple plugins before we go deep into how they get used. The big thing is, again, when we look at this file that was set up, we did say these were the plugins that we were going to use. I've got a couple that I've handwritten. So I've got a Dave Cloud one that's against the U key. There's an FCF open one, which is against the O key. I wrote one called FCD, which is another FCF plugin that's against the C key. Now you can see within our plugin variable here, all of our plugins here are set against the key command that we'd like to use and then what plugin wants to get used. So knowing that, let's close that out now so that we understand how that works. Let's close this terminal. And then let's go and look at where we put all these plugins. So if you jump into the plugins folder within NNN, the biggest thing that you need to know is that NNN by default does not install the plugins. You need to tell it which plugins you want to do. If you're just a brand new user, what I would suggest is just making a config folder, call it NNN plugins, and just output all of the plugins in there. So what you're going to want to do is come in here. There's an install procedure. If you run this curl command within a folder that you've created, again, this config NNN plugins folder, what you're going to end up with is a duplication of all these plugin files within that directory. At that point, you can then export that variable to your environment and say, these are the plugins that I would like to use. So for example, I was only using maybe three or four of these as a full subset. Now let's go and look at what these plugins actually do. To do that, I'm going to show off one thing that NNN is really good at, and that's working with other plugin systems. So for example, I use something called Jump, which just lets me get to folders really quickly, like jump to my video folder or jump to my wallpaper folder. NNN can call this as well. So for example, I can jump in here and NNN, I'm now within my wallpaper folder. But if I want to, I can invoke my plugins and you invoke that by hitting semicolon. And then again, it's bringing up that key command system here on the bottom. This matches against the variables that I exported earlier in my fish config. So I'm going to hit the J key, which is what I have tied to that jump system. And when I do that, I could say, well, where would you like to jump to? Well, maybe I'd like to jump to EUI. EUI is my React component library that I write. It's open source. I'd check it out. It's really cool. But now I can jump and look against the files that are within that directory. Plugins are a lot more useful than that. I can hit semicolon again to load up that that plugin window, and then I'm going to hit the P key. The P key, or the preview plugin system, is really neat because what it allows me to do is actually page through my files over here on this left side, and you're seeing that it's actually catting out, or in fact, in this case, it's using a program called Bat and pushing it to a different terminal window. Now, depending upon the terminal window that you might be using, for example, you might be using Kitty or you might be using a TMUX system, it's either going to open up a separate terminal or it's going to output it within a separate TMUX pane or a Kitty pane or something like that. The really cool thing that you just need to understand is once I've done that preview, it's going to do its best to try and preview against each one of those files. In this case, for me, it's using BAT, which is why I'm getting all the cool syntax highlighting here. But you notice as I go over a directory, it's actually using the command line program tree, which will give me a tree for that entire system. Now we can use this for things, not just this kind of preview that just goes out to a terminal. And to show that off, let's kill this one and let's use a different plugin. Let's use that C one that I had written. This is an FCF plugin, which just allows me to go to any directory that I want to. I want to get back to that wallpapers directory. So I'm just typing wall here. I'm hitting enter. It's going to jump me over to that wallpaper directory. If I want to do, again, that preview over here, I can do that, but you'll notice that I'm getting like kind of ugly versions of the images. This is using a program called Vue. And it's important to know when you're working with these things, when you look at the plugins, it's going to tell you the name of the plugin. So for example, I'm using the preview plugin here, the preview 2E1 in here. And if we were to look through that file, if we come in here and look for the images one, which is right here, this block here around 150 or so, you'll see that it basically checks to see what I have installed on my computer, and then we'll pipe that out and see what's there. So for example, I've got a command line program called Vue installed. And what that does is it's going to just do a terminal-based version of what that image is. I like using this specifically because it's so fast. A lot of times I just need the basics of what a file looks like to be like, oh, that's right, that's the one of like Red Mars or something. But more than likely, you don't want to, see something like that. You'd like to see something a little bit better. And again, this is where that plugin system is really neat. I can instead hit semicolon, and I'm going to invoke my image plugin. And when I do that, it's going to launch it up in a separate program. And this is in the image viewer program that's called, I believe it's SXIV. I always forget the name of this one. One thing I could say for command line programs is they make it fairly impossible for you to remember what they're called. But this one just allows me to basically use an image viewer and I can look through these images however I want. This is obviously a lot more fidelity than what I was looking at before. I can then even hit enter on here and get sort of a thumbnail view of these images, load them up. If I want to scroll, zoom in, I can. I can move around. These are all key commands. They're not key commands that are tied to NNN itself. It's tied to this specific program. And again, what's really, really neat is NNN is just a way to link to those other programs that are out there. So more than likely, what you're going to do when you first use NNN is you're going to be like, I've never heard of this stuff before, but I'd like to get images. And then you start using these tools in concert together, and you really, really understand the power of how NNN works. One way to show that off in a really good way is let's show a program that I've, a plugin that I've written myself. It's the most basic of plugins that are available, but it'll give you an idea of how to write your own. So again, I'm in this wallpaper directory. I'm going to invoke my plugin system by hitting semicolon, and then I'm going to hit the U key. And the U key for me is upload. And what it's going to do is you can see it's giving me a notification here. It's uploaded that file. And that's really awesome to me. Like, I'm a web designer. I'm more often than not having to always make images or take screen captures of wherever I'm at. I may have to upload a video for somebody. And so it's really nice to just be able to navigate through the directory structure, hit the U key, and just have it uploaded immediately. Now, I'm not going to show you the very specifics of how this script works. I'm just going to talk to you about the plugin side of it. So, getting to the plugins of NNN, again, you should remember where those things live. They live in that config NNN plugins directory. Let's look at the one that I was using. it's a good time to talk about how NNN works. Anything that works in Vim, more than likely it works in NNN as well. I can do a forward slash and start searching for, I know mine is called Dave Cloud, and we can look at this file itself. And if we look at it again, like I previewed, this is the most boring file in the world. All that it actually does is it copies the file that's under my selection, and then it moves it to the Dave Cloud in directory. Now, there's a lot more scripting that goes on beyond that. I don't think you need to learn how that works. All you need to know is when I drop a file there, I've got a script that watches for it and then shoots it off to my own custom domain and uploads that file there. NNN's plugin, really all it needs to know is I need you to copy the file that's available, and that's coming through with this $1 variable that's coming in, and I'm just copying it over to that directory. That's as basic as an NNN plugin gets. They can get a little bit more specific though. So let's look at something a little more advanced. This is also a good time to kind of show you off one of the really strong advantages that I think NNN has, and that's you can actually call it within Vim. So there's an nnn.vim plugin, and what that allows me to do is I can actually invoke NNN within Vim itself, and I like just bringing it over as a really small view on this right side. And then I can just navigate around. If I wanted to, I could jump, and if I wanted to, jump to that wallpaper. All the same things that I was doing within NNN before, I can now do within this version of NNN within Vim. I know it's kind of inception-y, but like once you start doing this stuff, it just starts getting so cool, and you can really navigate around your files really quickly. So I want to get back to that directory that we were at before. So I'm going to hit the dash key. This is really cool. It's just like doing cd dash as we saw before. I could even, for example, hit tilde, and that's going to take me, whoops, that wasn't where I wanted to go. I wanted to go to tilde, and then that'll take me to my home directory. There's a lot of these like little hidden tricks that are really logical once you think about it within NNN that just allow you to navigate around. So again, where I wanted to be though was within that folder directory within NNN itself. So let's close out of here. Let's open it back up. It's gonna bring us back there. So I think I was promising I was gonna show you a more complex plugin. Let's do this FCD one. This is the one that I've been using when I bring up FCF itself. And all that this one does is it's going to it's gonna invoke FCF through find. So find is another command line program. And it's gonna say use find, pipe it into FCF, and then whatever I select out of FCF, I'd like you to do this special command that NNN provides, which is NNN underscore CD, and that will allow me to jump to that directory. And so seeing that in practice, let's go open this up. Let's hit semicolon C. Here we now have our FCF version. I can, again, type wallpapers, hit enter, and it's gonna jump over there. That's the plugin that I've written. It's pretty simple, but it is using a couple of those helper scripts that the NNN plugin system works with. And you can see that gets loaded up here on this first line. It's saying, please put the NNN plugin helpers within here. It's really important to show you what really comes with that. The obvious one is this NNN CD thing that's here. But the more important thing that it does is it's got a couple config things that you can set up for it. So I'm gonna, again, I wanna load up NNN within my Vim. I'm gonna hit the dot key, and the dot key is going to show me all my hidden files within here. And the reason I did that is because I wanna find one specific, that NNN plugin helper one. See, if I hit that dot, it actually drops out. And when I load up in here, there's one specific setting that I think is really important to know when you're working with NNN, and that is the current CTX variable that's set here. And I've got it set to 1. By default, it comes with a setting of 0. And let's look at what happens when you set it to 0. If we were to run NNN, and then we ran FCF plugin that I was running, and let's say again I want to go to that wallpapers one. When I hit enter in here, it's going to ask for which context that I would like to load. this is, you know, something that you may want to change. You may be switching and using contacts quite a lot. I don't use them very much. So I'm always hitting enter here again, and then that's just going to load it in the context that I was at. It might be important to talk to you a little bit about what contacts are, why they're important. So contacts are, and let's make this a little bigger. Contacts are the 1, 2, 3, and 4 up at the top of that file. What they are is essentially tabs. Think of them as tabs. If you want to, you could have two contacts open at one time. I'm just going to hit the number 2. I now have a separate context that's open. I can then come to my home directory. And in context 1, I have the wallpapers directory. In context 2, I have my home directory. And let's say I wanted to take a couple of these files. I'm just going to select them by hitting space. Pick that one as well. Let's go over to context 2. And then let's place those by hitting P. Within this context. And that gives us a really easy way to switch and jump back and forth within context. Again, if you, I know I'm hitting a lot of key commands here. If you ever get lost, you don't know what you're doing, you can always hit the question mark, and then that will give you the key commands for NNN itself. I can learn in here, for example, that the X key is what's going to allow me to delete files once I've selected them. Let's use that one now. Select these 4 wallpaper files. Let's hit X. It's going to ask, do you want it for the selection or the current? I'm going to say the selection. I'm going to hit the Y key to delete them. They're gone. But how we ended up here, we were talking about context and having to switch that stuff. If you change this over to 1 instead of 0, which is what I'm going to do now, I think this is a much more sane setting. What this allows you to do, again, is when you are browsing around or using those plugins, like for example, I want to go back to that wallpaper. Now when I just hit enter, it's going to take me directly within the context that I was in, not ask for a confirmation. I think that kind of shortcuts things quite a bit, makes it really simple. So again, that's the plugin system. I think it's really neat. It really gives you a lot of these fun things that you can do. The last thing that I think I might want to show off here is let's show off one frustration that I always have within terminals, and I think a lot of people always have, is like, at some point you're going to be here and you're going to want to do a drag and drop. And you can't drag and drop within a terminal. It's just, it's not really possible. But there are plugins that NNN has. There's one in here called the drag and drop plugin, which really just uses this separate command line program called Dragon. And Dragon, which we're going to invoke here, allows you to, when I hit D, it's going to say, do you want the file or the directory? I'm going to tell it the file. And then what it's going to do is give me a draggable version of that file that we had selected, which is this Michael Oswald file. I can now drag it and get a nice preview of that image that's there. So pretty neat. I can then come in here, and close that out, close this file out, close that file out, close that file out, and then I can basically do that sort of stuff with the plugin. So again, NNN is something that is very flexible once you realize that you can use a bunch of other really cool plugins that are already there. The sky is really the limit with this stuff. A lot of people use it even as like a music browser, for example. I just like it for its speed of being able to get around stuff. And again, I use it within Vim as just a file directory and as a file preview. So it's really cool if you like it. I think that describes the real basics of what this system does. If you enjoy it, you have questions about it, ask me questions in the comments. I'm more than happy to let you know what's up. Hope you enjoyed the video.